YouTube, we are back with another video. And I know you guys, a lot of you guys have come around to my channel, are used to the My Team content. And I told you guys I was going to be diversifying, not only on 2K on the channel, but just in general. So this is one of those videos that, you know, I just wanted to try out and just see, you know, test the waters in some park and some My Player Builders and things like that. Now, in this video, we're going to be creating the best perimeter lockdown build and just lockdown build in general, in my opinion, in NBA 2K22 next gen. Now keep in mind, this is a next gen build, so if you guys are new to the next gen, you know, park scene, you're new to just 2K in general, you came to the right place. And without further ado, you know what I'm saying, let's go ahead and hop right into it. And if you guys do enjoy the video, if it does help you out, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to the channel if you're new and all that good stuff. I'm not going to use my rebirth on this build, but let's go ahead and hop into it. So the first thing what you want to do is you want to pick small forward, at least for the build that I am showing you guys. I haven't really, you know, messed around with power forwards or anything like that, but I have found that, you know, small forward seems to be the best build when it comes to lockdowns. Now handiness, obviously this does not matter, it just comes down to your preference. I personally go right-handed and things like that, and jersey number quite clearly just doesn't matter as well, so we're gonna go ahead and get into that. So what you're gonna want to do here, because you know height is gonna change a lot of the things on the build, and so does weight. But what you want to do is keep your height at this, you know, default setting. That is the best thing, the best height for this lockdown build, the best height for what you want to do with this build specifically. Now what you're also going to do is lower your weight all the way down. This guy's not going to really be much of a, I don't want to say he's not going to be a paint presence, but he's not going to be that just, you know, big man type of player. This is going to be more so playing like the 2 through the 4 type of thing. And you know, lowering your weight and things like that is going to up your speed. It's going to help with your perimeter defense and just overall just help you have a better experience as a perimeter lockdown on this game. Now, the next thing that you're going to want to do in this build is you're going to want to max out your wingspan. Maxing out your wingspan is super, super important, simply for the fact that, you know, this build is going to get Hall of Fame Interceptor, and Hall of Fame Interceptor with a 7'4" wingspan, you know, max out wingspan on a 6'7" player is crazy. Trust me, you get a lot of crazy, crazy steals, and it's going to be just that much more fun for you to play with. Now, the thing with body shape and things like that is, this doesn't really matter. It is going to change your player build a little bit. It's not going to change that much, but me personally, I really went with define. Again, you don't have to follow exactly what I'm doing, but you know, you can't go wrong with any of them. So, but I personally went with define when making this build. Now, getting into the stats, the most important stats, I do have it here on my phone right here, so if you see me looking down, that is what I'm looking at. The base stats that you guys want to focus on is going to be driving dunk. You want to move your driving dunk up to a 92. This gives you half limitless takeoff, it gives you you know, slithery, you have Lob City finisher on gold, that's good enough, and this is good enough for you to get all of your dunk packages. So that is something that is really important when it comes to that. That is one of the biggest, you know, stats in this game when it comes to that. Now, you're gonna want to put your layup at an 80. This gets you silver, fearless finisher, gives you that threshold to there. So just to up that, you know, badge, and you get an extra finishing badge as well. The next thing you're gonna want to focus on, that you're gonna want to come over here to, is gonna be, you're gonna want to max out your three-pointer. At a 79 three ball, you get 16 shooting badges, and then when you max, well, not necessarily max out, but if you get your mid-range shot to that 75, it's that perfect threshold to get 21 shooting badges. And then if you touch the free throw as well, the free throw on this build you're gonna want to do is 84. This is really mainly if you want to play you know, rec pro-am and things like that, but if you want to play part, you can obviously tinker around with it. You don't have to touch your free throw at all, and you can, you know, put it on other things. Now, the next most important thing is going to be your ball handle. You're going to want to max this out to a 75, not max it out, but you want to put it at a 75. This gets you silver hyperdrive, and it's a good threshold to do that. Now you can put it up to a 76 to get that extra badge, and depending on if you don't want to upgrade your free throw or not, you can upgrade your ball handle to an 82 and things like that. It might change the name of the build, I will let you guys know that, but you can kind of, like I said, mess around with it, but this is just what I went with personally. Now the thing with pass accuracy, I know a lot of you guys probably already know this, but for my guys that are pretty new into the 2K scene, your pass accuracy is, you're gonna want to have that up to a 70. This gives you access to silver bullet passer, bronze dimer, and silver bullet passer, trust me, is enough if you're just a wing player. It is good enough to get the job done for you. You'll have a lot of success with it. You won't throw like super slow passes, and you won't really throw a lot of turnovers with it. I mean, I'm not guaranteeing that you're not going to throw turnovers, but it's going to help you not throw as many turnovers. Now your speed with ball, you're going to want to put that up to a 72. You can put it at 73 to get Hoff downhill if you really want to, but I found it to where 72 is the best. But again, you can put it on 73 if you guys want. The reason why we put it on 72 is so that we can, have other stats be a little bit higher, because you're not going to really have the ball in your hand that much, running the break, things like that. So it might not be, your best interest to do it. But if you want that Hall of Fame downhill, you do have that option to go up one more stat. Now here we get into the bread and butter of the build. You're going to want to put your perimeter defense to a 95. This gets you all of these Hall of Fame badges. You're going to get Hoff ankle braces, Hoff hustler, Hoff menace, clamps, pick dodger, tireless defender, defensive leader, pickpocket, not pickpocket, but you get what I'm saying. Look at all those Hall of Fame badges you get off of that. And with the plus four, we actually don't get plus four in next gen, so ignore what I was about to say with that. I completely forgot about that. But another really, really important thing when it comes to this is maxing out your steal. You get 96 steal, and that grants you Hoff pickpocket. Now Hoff pickpocket isn't as good as it once was when the game first came out. It's still really good, but it's not as good as it once was when it comes to that. But getting that 96 steal, trust me, is going to really help you out when you get that. You get a lot of Hoff badges. That's really what it comes down to. You have a lot of options, and you can really, diversify with a lot of the options that you do have. Now, what you're gonna want to do next is upgrade your block, max it all the way out. You don't necessarily have to max it all the way out. The most important thing when it comes to that is, if you want to just get it the perfect threshold, you're going to want to put it on a 83. But me personally, I put it on 87 just so that I can have a little bit more. Again, you don't have to put it all the way up, but just to maximize it, you guys really want to get into the nitty gritty of it, you can put it at an 83. But I personally put mine all the way maxed out. Again, just some different things you can do with the build as a whole. Now your offensive rebound, you're gonna want to put that at a 77. You honestly can put it at the 79 threshold as well, so that you can get silver worm if you really care about worm that much. And the next threshold, to get the most badges out of your offensive rebound is going to be that 77, which is why I put it at 77. Now your defensive rebound, you're gonna want to have that at an 86. The 86 is the perfect threshold to get you 30 defensive badges. And again, if you want gold worm, you can put it up to 89. Again, you're not going to be like too far inside the paint. So again, having it at that 86 is going to be probably the most important. Now, moving over to the vitals, you're going to want to put your speed at an 82. No really rhyme or reason for that. That's just the maxed out of it. You're going to want to max out your acceleration as well. You don't want to touch strength because you're not really going to be messing with that in the paint. And you're going to want to put your vert to an 85. This grants you all of the dunk packages that you guys are going to want, that you guys are going to want to be able to use. I just realized my post control is up. You don't want to touch that at all. And obviously you don't want to touch the interior defense as well. It's not going to be that much of a difference to you guys. Trust me, it's not going to be that much of a difference. Now you're going to want to put your stamina to 90. Again, if you're not playing rec, if you're not playing pro-am and things like that, you might not want to put it up as high as I did personally, but you can definitely, mess around with it if you guys want to. I just realized my face cam is in the way. Let me slide that over actually. There we go. Yeah, and that is going to be it for the physicals. Again, if you guys want to look at it, I apologize for my face cam being in the way, but yeah, that's what you're going to want to do with it. Now, again, you guys can kind of mess around with it here. You have a little bit of wiggle room when it comes to it. And you guys can kind of decide what you guys want to do with it. Now, what I did, I think I just put my extra stuff on ball handle. You can put it on your ball handle if you really, really want to. You can put it on your speed with ball, again, just so you can get that off downhill. But again, I personally went with extra ball handle just in case. But I mean, you know, again, you know, it is personal preference. It is 100% up to you. And I mean, you can easily just touch some of the other stats and change it slightly. But this is going to be the final numbers on this build. 92 driving dunk, 79 three ball, 75 mid range, 85 free throw, 70 pass accuracy, 79 ball handle, 72 speed with ball. And obviously, pretty much all your defensive stats are going to be pretty much maxed out, if not all the way maxed out. And you're going to want to max out your speed, acceleration. Don't want to max out your vert. Don't want to max out your stamina, because this is pretty much going to be good enough to get the job done for you guys. Now, when it comes to takeovers, I am a proponent of, if you're going to be a lock, putting on, you know, your lock badges. You really can go, you can't go wrong with any of these, if I'm being 100% honest. And you really can't go wrong with any of the finishing badges as well. You're not going to really want to put on these because you're not going to be running the center position. But if you do end up, because I know a lot of people's friend group struggle to have big men, if you really, really want to, you can go with these as well. But for the purpose of this video, for the purpose of this build, what you're going to want to do is put on enhanced jump shot contest. I promise you, you're going to get jump shot contest from literally the free throw line if somebody's at 3-point line. It's insane. And you can kind of go either or with perimeter badge drop or extreme clamps. I personally find more success with extreme clamps, but perimeter badge drop is also a really good one. So these are the two takeovers that I personally run primarily, but you know, you can kind of, you know, go based off of what you guys want to do. Now, obviously, this build that I made is a perimeter lockdown. The one that I have in my like actual my career is a two-way finisher, but the builds are basically the same. I think I changed a little bit when it came to this build, but for the most part, you're gonna want to be able to, you know, have this perimeter lockdown build. That is going to be it for the build. I'm going to probably make a little bit more of these kind of build videos. So if you guys want to see more of them, definitely let me know in the comment section. Let me know if you did enjoy it. Let me know if this build does help you out. And if it does, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe to the channel if you're new and all that good stuff. But other than that, hopefully you guys did enjoy it, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.